through the trailer where I grew up. Well, it's not there anymore.
Yeah.
Because it's a new trailer now. You'll find everything here. This is space number 6. This is where I grew up. Not the same trailer anymore. But this is where I grew up right here. This space right here. See, it was basically like this, right?
You put the pad.
Hey, Bobber.
Yeah.
You put it on.
Put it on.
Eso. Eso es todo. No que no. No que no sabía, güey. Eh? A ver, tú, échale, vente. Uno, dos. We have a big family, you know, 7 brothers and sisters. My parents, we lived in a 1-bedroom trailer for, I was 2 when I moved here, and I was 13 when I moved away, so about 11 years, you know.
You ready for Gamboa?
I'm ready for whoever. Whoever they put, I'm ready for, whoever.
Peanut butter you jelly time.
Peanut butter jelly time. You against Katsidas.
We go fight. That'd be a good fight for the fans. I would love it because it'll be 2 war going at it.
You against
it'll be like Mickey Ward and Arturo Gatti.
You against Amir Khan?
I'm here to fight, you know. I gotta bring my boxing shoes.
Now what can you tell me about your father? He's a legendary trainer. He trained Fernando Vargas. He got you into boxing. Your brothers.
Right. You know, my dad is his passion is boxing. But he, you know, he's done a great job, you know, since I remember him, you know, when I was in school, he would get up at 5 in the morning, take me and Fernando Vargas running at the beach, and then we come home, he'd have to go to work in the strawberry fields for 8 hours, and then
he did?
Oh, yeah. Eight to 10 hours a day, and then come to the gym at 5 p.m. with his boots full of strawberries and his clothes all dirty, and still train me and Fernando. He did that for many years. And
he was a very strict trainer, everybody tell me. Like, no joke. Like, your gym is all jokes and clowns, they're practical jokes. With him, it wasn't like that.
Oh, no. It's like you're in
basic
you're
training.
You're in the military with my dad. And you know, that's one thing I'm doing the way I'm doing it. Because a lot of fighters, at least in my case, and Roy Jones said the same thing, Nonito Runner, same thing. You know, when we were talking about it in the HBO meeting with Nonito, Roy said the same thing. You know, Nonito went through the same thing. And, you know, when you go through that, your body, your head just gets crazy and you want to quit. You know, that happened to me at 26. I'm like, forget this. You know, I want to get out of boxing. And I did. You know, Nonito said he went through the same thing a couple times when his dad was training him, because his dad was the same way. So you know, you got to have fun. You got to enjoy training. You got to come to the gym and play, have fun with everybody. When it comes to training, yeah, we do our job. You know, Brandon gets his rounds in. Nonito gets his rounds in. But it's gotta be fun. You gotta enjoy doing it, and that's the way I'm doing it. And hey, it's been working. So if there's coaches out there, or there's people out there that say that I don't take training serious, and that our gym is always you know, like a joke, you know, that we're always playing around. Well, you know, it's been effective.
They save it in hospitals. They bring people in to joke with the patients. It makes people feel relaxed.
Remember Patch Adams?
Yeah.
Patch Adams did that, and you know, once you know, the kids are there sick, and he comes and makes them smile, makes them laugh. Come on, you know, that's already helping out the kid, you know, by making them smile, making.
Why
them
don't
laugh.
You have Donald put on a nose like that and dress up like a clown
and start making everybody laugh? No, because the kids are already laughing just by having Pelau in my gym. They're already laughing.
What can you tell me about Robert Garcia?
Oh, Robert's the man, dude. He's a perfect example of you know, of how you can succeed in life if you keep working hard and you follow your dreams.
There's a lot of trailers around here where they park their van, like I'm not saying this van,
yeah,
but they park their van into their driveway or something, and they have people stay in there.
And
in
they
their
charge
van.
The rent.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. They do
you also
that.
Told me that they rent space
under the trailer.
Yeah,
there's some. I don't know which trailers, but I know Pelau would know which ones. You know, Pelau would know. See this van? We got like 15 people there coming out of work. You see that?
And they're all going to sleep now.
They're all going to one room, I'll bet you.
What did Robert Garcia teach you?
He taught me speed.
Okay, show me speed on this back. What else did he teach you?
He taught me how to knock out people. I'll go to the body. You know, I'll go like that, and I'll put the fucking sock on.
But you don't do that in the street, right?
No.
Not in school, right?
Only
you can't.
Only
in the gym? And why do you love boxing so much?
Because it's something I can do and I enjoy it.
And what would you say to people say, oh, MMA and we like other sports? What would you tell them?
Karate.
I'll tell them, nah, that ain't a cool sport. That sucks.
He's on the carry the trash.
Look at that. See that? Look at that.
Special delivery. Wow, that's pretty stable.
So cool.
Doing a reality show.
We're doing a reality show about Robert Garcia. Right, what can you tell me about him?
Who, my buddy right here?
Yeah.
No, we go back then, man.
Wow, since we're like 6 years old.
What was it like living here? What was it like living in the commercial?
Ghetto, he still lives here.
What's it like to live
it's
here?
Fucking fun. I told you we used to have fun.
It's like little TJ right here.
Why? See? It's a whole.
It's all community. Everybody get along and shit.
Everybody knows.
If I need a new social security,
you find it.
You find it here. You need some witchcraft. Everything here.
So if you get in trouble here, who do you call first? The police or the gang members?
Hell no. We deal right here, man. Down with some homies right here.
Just take care of business.
Yeah. You had to handle them right there.
Yeah, can't call
Chucky
the cops.
Broke some fucking tools right here the other day.
Who's Chucky?
Right here. The child's play.
This Chucky right there.
Oh.
He broke somebody's
tooth. We didn't see in the light. Hold it in that angle for like that for a second. No, the other way, this way. Yeah.
That's Chucky right there.
So Robert, you're saying the police put a camera on the top of the tower?
Hey, I'm not lying about that one. It's true.
Yeah, he used to work for them too.
Is this to monitor what goes on here?
Yeah.
Why do they need to monitor it? Why
I don't know. They say it's crazy here.
Is it?
They do have it as supposedly one of the rough areas in Oxnard, but not really.
That's what I said. A lot of people you ask, they just go to commercials. They don't want to come in here.
Say now about all his success. He's training some of the best fighters. He was a world champion.
I just seen the fight with Donito Donaire. He did good.
And what does that say? Do you know the trainer behind him?
Yeah, he's doing good. Oh. Yeah, tattoo. You want to get tattooed right here, right now?
Every tattoo, too, everything.
I'm telling you, you don't have to leave here. Whatever you want, you'll find here.
All right, we'll have to come back. The next time I come back, we'll come back on a weekend. We'll check. Felipe Campe, you were a former, if I'm not mistaken, you were a former WBC Youth Champion of the World.
Yes.
And what are you doing these days? Are you still involved in boxing?
Nah, just work.
Just work? Yeah. Why didn't you continue?
This motherfucker, I've told him so many times. How come, you know, I'm telling you, this guy's, you know, he's been like one of my best friends.
Yeah.
And motherfucker don't even show up to my gym anymore. He goes once in a great while. At least go fucking volunteer with the kids, right?
Yeah.
Put him in the spot, Ellie, come on.
I've been working, man.
Motherfucker.
But what does it mean that Oxnard developed so much talent in boxing? Why is that?
Just good trainers.
Does it ever help you on the street, the knowledge of boxing?
Yeah.
You need to use it sometimes.
In the bars.
In the bars?
Oh, me and him, we used to go to bars, we used to fuck. Oh, man, you don't want to know. If we still be able to do that during the reality show, then you have a real fucking reality show. We used to use the crazy.